Alright, to tell you the truth, I'm not entirely certain what level of difference there will be between my voice and the PC audio when I decide to bring the former of those into the mix, but based on some of the levels here, it doesn't seem to be too much of a difference. Too much of a lopsided disadvantage in one side at any rate. Which is usually what I aim for. I'll try to, but yes, I'm here. Somehow. Actually been here for a hot minute, but you know, just been busy with a bunch of other stuff as per the usual. It always remains a mystery exactly how, or when, or in what fashion, which I'm pretty sure is just redundant, but I'm gonna say that regardless, in what fashion I'm actually gonna be able to accomplish whatever it is I'm trying to accomplish right now. But I suppose right now, what that would be, tell hello to whosoever may be present at this time, by the way. Should probably try to not neglect saying that, but what I should be trying to do right now, basically, is see if I can go ahead and play a game that has been pretty much another of the, at least thankfully somewhat small right now, back burner lump, specifically for my stream sets. Get a bender and one that I didn't actually begin yet, though, I believe. Pretty much the only one that can, about which that can be said. Sounds like that Crowley guy. Don't hate Lagan. Perhaps so. Perhaps to a certain extent, I don't know if I have quite the necessary cadence for that sort of finish lilt, which I believe is correct, that you would get with Crowley, but there may be something at least somewhat comparable going on. Oh boy, speaking of somewhat comparable, what a blush from the past is to hear about, let's make it three now, as I mentioned, like, three people from my extremes. Oh boy, also, which I not only have this very bizarre and inconvenient overlap of audio, but also a mild rate party on the OBS bitrate, which was being an annoyance a couple days ago when I tried to do this. But now, let's see here. I want to believe the audio levels are maybe a little bit less. About that much. Probably close enough for sufficiently confined within the confines of fine. But yes, I will attempt to play this game if I can first accomplish the first thing that would lead to that being something that will be executed properly on the stream, which is to make it visible. And there we go. Game that I believe I have not played with any kind of regularity since, like, the one time that I actually finished, like, just a vanilla game on, how long ago was that? I'm pretty sure I can just look at the, like, achievements unlock dates and figure that out. Around early 2016.
Nice.
Oh goodness, that is Isquen. Oh hello, how's it going? Welcome to me sort of kind of awkwardly trying to shuffle with things in a way that I am perennially unfamiliar with and try to play video games. Let's see. I suppose I kind of trying to figure out if there's like an alternative way that I can set this up to where it won't just stop everything if I click off the window, which would probably be a little bit more convenient, but what happens if I do say no full screen? Okay, because right now it is full screen and it says no border, but it's still gonna do that thing, right? Well, I guess the main thing that I would want to figure out is if I do this, okay, even if I do this and it says it's off, it's still gonna do that thing, so maybe not. Well, I'm gonna put it on no border. I don't know if that actually makes any kind of a significant difference. I'm just gonna go ahead and leave that there. Why is there a separate setting for window border, though? If you have, like, full screen no border, well, I guess there is a technical difference, but yeah. I don't believe I want to fuck with anything else, so I can't, like, address this one small grievance with the way things are done. I know I don't want to delete data though. There is a possibility, however thin, that I may actually have some leftover data from when I did this lesson. Apparently I do. There you go. What do you know? This was several years before I ever played the chase, and yet it also echoes the name of the person who requested this some time back. By some time back, I'm pretty sure I mean several months back, but ooh, you know how it is. But there's also ak, and kak, I guess I admit it's a thematic thing. But yes, pretty much all there is to it is that I think many years ago I played some of the base game on stream, and then I don't believe I streamed the ending of the main game, but I did do that on my own, and then the other two, these other two modes, I guess it's the other three now, so you can tell. I tried out, but I never really finished or got terribly far into, and now there is also a fourth mode, which I never even touched. But I suppose we're gonna do this, I'm gonna try to do it somewhat properly. Which is to say, I guess we'll just stick with the first page profile simply. What's this? Copy and delete, that's all that is. So instead of just having this be well, maybe we will leave it, this like fourth slot is like a symbolic blank. For if I ever, I don't know, feel like I want to play the King Knight mode on my own, but right now we're gonna start a new game as just regular Shovel of Hope, methinks, taking away to the main storyline. But not before I look at all of these little write-ups for the it occurs to me though that for some reason that stopped being visible on the stream at one point, and I did not realize until this very moment. Way to go, me. Well, it shouldn't really matter. It's all the same crap that I've been looking at, which I'm not even sure if it was visible. Probably not, but not much more to it than that. We're not going back to the title theme. And a quick pop in and pop out, sadly I'm wiped. Unfortunately, but understandable. And also, you know, if I haven't said that already, you had my condolences for what happened, and I hope that it doesn't go as roughly as it could, but just kind of hope that it goes in a manner that is what's the best word to express the to tactfully express what I'm trying to say, you know, way that is culpable. I don't know, probably shouldn't dwell on that too much anyway. But what was I doing, trying to figure out what all of these little splash descriptions are, all four of them. Take away for the main storyline, toss bombs in this tricky alternate quest, legendize of the tragic prequel, and match brains on Brownie's real prequel, which I'm still kind of questioning, scratching my head as to how exactly that's gonna end up working when I eventually get to it. But now let's just get started with the main show here. Oh god, I'm not even sure what name I should pick. I'm guessing it's 8 letters based on what I just saw. Up to 8 letters. Don't we try to make this a thematic thing with all these different profiles? Oh, it's up to 9 letters, in fact. I don't want to go with Blue Dead. Actually, no. Since we have the, you know, the extra space, why don't you go ahead and there. Add a little bit of a stylization to it. Okay, what is this? Before you begin, would you like to show the bodies of any characters in the main cast in the photo section during the post maybe? Like what? What happens if I pick yes? I genuinely have no idea what this is. What? What's the point of this? Okay, I kind of regret ever even asking that question of what the heck this is supposed to be for. I just leave it as a default. I definitely do not want to fuck with that. Can't imagine why that even exists as an option, but well, let's just go ahead and get into it. Many years ago today, the lands were untamed and roamed by legendary adventurers. In a style that also makes me remember how I am very, I am, maybe not very, but I am somewhat partial to some of the things that provide the inspiration for this game as a whole, and I am very partial against some of those other things. I suppose my mind is kind of trying to just figure out a balance between the two. I suppose there wasn't anybody else who could possibly do the same thing that Shovel Knight was doing before, not one person. So, oh well, nothing for it. And you know, since now that we've been streaming for over 20 minutes, which is not that much, but it's all about perspective, considering that what I wanted to mention right now is, since it's going to mention, well, like we pop in and pop out, it's probably going to be not too far off for what. Oh shit, that was a good start. For what this stream is probably going to end up being like, just because I started quite just a wee bit later than my anticipation. Okay, so I need to refamiliarize myself with this control, so it's like one of those things that I had legitimately forgotten about. That was pretty much a direct inspiration for this gameplay slash design, which is DuckTales. I don't think I really spent too much time with DuckTales, but I can remind myself that in order to do the point at the ground with your shovel thing, you just have to hit down while you're in the air and not like hold the attack button. And then, hold the attack button and then hold down. Only one part of that is necessary. Which, I don't know, I feel like I probably played at least one game that had a similar mechanic where, you know, doing that with two buttons is what you gotta do, but I don't really come up with what that game may have been at this time. Oh well. I'm sure we do want to farm as much money as possible, though. Not because of the pragmatic notion of wanting to. Actually, wait a minute. Wait, what? Okay, I wasn't expecting that to hurt me, I will say. But if not for the pragmatic notion of just wanting to get a high score, then certainly the fact that I'm pretty sure there's plenty of ways to lose money by actually getting stuff from the town area. And perhaps elsewhere as well. Sure, this does have some places where you can, in fact, do what I'm failing to do right now, and like try to find some kind of passageway, secret passageway into the wall. If only I could remember, but I'm afraid it's been. That's definitely too much of a tall order right now. Oh boy. I will say, though, I am certainly grateful for the notion that. Okay. The notion that I do not have a time limit to get through all these stages, because I do definitely like the idea to, or the ability, as opposed to just take a step back and think about what I'm doing. The feeling that if I expect to not die horribly in quite a few of these stages, that's definitely going to be the case if, you know, memory is anything to go by. I mean, there is an olden time in which I did manage to get through all of them. Already, but that is a time long past. Okay, so judging from this, yes, you have stuff like this, but I suppose judging from these couple examples, there's some kind of visual indicator, at least, that you can in fact do that. There's like a little gem stuck into the wall that lets you know that you can blast away that bit of wall, or just like a more obvious kind of, I don't know, oofy looking block with a diagonal line going through it, like it seems to be the case here. I'm actually kind of wondering how simple it would be to stop bouncing if that is your prerogative. I'm glad to remember why you want these physical note pages, but I'm pretty sure there's a reason. think there's a couple of those things that show up as like a recurring thing in these stages, from what I recall. Well, there is that thing, and then there may be another that maybe is not like an every single stage thing, but just like a, you get this and you can unlock an upgrade that you wouldn't be getting otherwise if you complete this like little bonus room. Oh, I'm surprised that little dragon didn't die in one hit, considering that it didn't seem to be presenting that as like a... Hey, if you mess this up, you can't get this one jewel, but it won't seem like a big deal. Because it's just like this one jewel, but at the same time... for that reason, we're not going to give you another chance to get it. Oh boy. Even I do seem to have a bit of a hard time stopping the bounce. Sometimes, once I've initiated that. Of course, I don't know if maintaining the bounce is also what makes some of these gems appear, or if they were going to appear regardless. I get the impression that maybe, just maybe, the former is true. See, it looks like there's a little bit of green stuck in the ball here, but it won't go away, so... I don't know, maybe I'm just not perfectly attuned to the whatever the visual indicators are for. Maybe there's a secret here. Oh, hey, Dodger. Let's roll some luck. Sounds like a jukebox feature. That makes sense. But I'm now trying to figure out if I should be going this way or if I should be going the other way. I'm paranoid about missing stuff, which I'm pretty sure you can just redo levels in this, but even so... Oh, shit. Whichever one of these, I was gonna say, whichever one of these seems like, wait a minute. I saw that chest. There we go. Whichever one of these seems like it's going to have, a longer set of rooms behind it is the one that I will do later, because that seems like that's going to be the intended way forward. So, after I've gotten this, oh boy, that's an effect when he holds up the last big jewel in the chest. Seems like it came directly from like an actual 8-bit game, but I don't know if that's the case or not. So I suppose I will go this way first. I mean, the fact that it takes a little bit more effort to get to does did make it seem like maybe that was not like the main way, but my inability to see the edge of the screen immediately kind of made me wary. Even when it did turn out that I didn't even have that on the other route either. Alright, there we go. Two note scrolls acquired in the same level even. What a concept. I wonder how these little dragons feel about the fact that they're constantly getting useless bouncing pads. In a way that probably hurts, and yet they are not granted the sweet release of death. That is not something that lies within their designated roles, I suppose. Oh boy. Will I be able to cheese this encounter in the same way as I did the last one? Probably. Not falling in the hole, I guess. Oh, like, exactly like that. I kind of saw that coming at the last possible moment, but could not act quickly enough to, you know, compensate for the fact that I had that knowledge. I was also kind of wondering on this screen if this is like, there's probably a few games that could be used as reference for what I'm thinking of right now, which is whether those dragons that like come at you on this screen, do they appear at fixed heights, or do they like, does their height depend on your position when they appear, but it does appear to be the former. I was gonna say, like, you know, what other games does that remind me of that also do that? Okay, there. Oh fuck. Well, I couldn't get, like, all the treasure, I guess, that comes from the first time that you kill this guy, but... I guess it doesn't matter terribly if we can... Oh, yeah. It does matter terribly, though, if I immediately get killed right after that. But hey, we got to talk about this screen some more since I have to go through it again. But yeah, now that I think about this kind of hazard where there's like birds that come at you just in a straight line from the edge of the screen. It like an example of a game that has something like that in this style would be like Ninja Gaiden or something, but for some reason the first game to come to mind for me was Skyblazer on Super Nintendo, which is like definitely a far more obscure example of that, I would imagine. Where most people are concerned. I'm pretty sure I didn't even, oh, okay, that guy needed to just kill himself. I suppose that works out. And I believe that there was probably some kind of another comparison I was gonna make, but I've already lost my train of thought. Perhaps another game in that style. That I was also going to reference, that probably is not something most people would be expected to know, and yet I guess it didn't impact me enough to where I could actually remember it in my absolutely atrocious short-term memory, but I don't know, I've just been going through a lot of different games from like that kind of a wheelhouse. NES and Super NES, because I ended up kind of obsessively putting a lot of different games on my 3DS now that I'm able to do so. And yet, you know, the irony and all that lies that I ended up spending a lot more time somewhere. I was slipping a little bit when I landed. Gonna have to try it out, but yeah, I end up spending a lot more time, you know, actually getting, like, going through lists of those games, recommendations and whatnot, and then actually trying to get a hold of those games than I do actually playing them. It's a very lopsided process, to be sure. Just as this shall be, question mark? Okay, I guess there was a bit of a low stutter on this sprite game from 2014. As we meet the Black Knight, in which these, you know, nearly 10 years that the game has been out surely has not been compared to something like the Monty Python Black Knight or anything like that. I'm sure that's not a joke that's been run into the ground repeatedly when people have streamed or let's play this game. Which is why I mention it, you know. No, rather, we could give him something else, like a characterization of someone who wants to take your money by convincing you to play his pinball table. That may be something a little bit more up my speed. The entire valley has been conquered by the Enchantress, though. Though we kind of gleaned quite a bit of this during the intro. We're about to figure this out. None of that matters because anyone after the Enchantress has to go through me. As we're told, steal thy shovel. I don't even remember if that's the, I don't think that is the, you know, the theme that's playing right now for this battle. I guess I can try to cheese him by not just doing vertical or horizontal strikes here. I'm not gonna be able to cheese this guy at all by, you know, doing what I've been doing so far, which is just trying to do DPS straight because he just has more health than we do. And something else that I didn't really remember about this game until I just realized it just now. Just the fact that... Oh shit. I believe you have limited lives, so you just have like the money that you lose each time you die. Which you can kind of make up. So not quite as grievous as it could be. I'm pretty sure you can also like break those checkpoints and like get more money, but... I don't feel like that would be something that would be advisable in my case. I think that would have a pretty result where I'm concerned. Okay. I guess we're just gonna wait for him to either corners like this, or failed corners like this, or taunt. I guess we can break him out of that cycle of jumps like I'm trying to do, and just kind of succeeded that once, and then didn't. It sure would be embarrassing if I were to lose now, wouldn't it? Oh, of course he didn't do it when I was in optimal position there, but... it's probably gonna be, fairly good prelude to how most of the boss encounters in this game are going to go, if also personal sort of recollection is any indication, as well as... as well as probably the, you know, these many-year-old bots of whatever those things are. If I were to look there, I would probably be seeing more of the same. I'm sure they're around somewhere. Oh boy. I also vaguely remember this now that I've seen this, but... even if I definitely would not have remembered it if I had been asked that beforehand. Well, I think we have to wake up. Handing up the fire only to find out that there were gems in the fire, which kind of makes me wonder what exactly we were burning to make the fire. And go back the same way we came, which will lead not to the plains where we just were, but rather... the village, where I suppose we must stop before we carry on further. No weapons we have enough to worry about lately without everyone swinging swords around. Well, what do you know, we don't have a sword. First, I have to talk to everyone, including me. A leech calling himself a super skeleton, jumping attacks are ferocious, and the Silla 2 horse head boss says that old fellow Chester is selling the relics I'm getting to buy some. You know your fishing rod can haul faraway bags and gems out of your reach, that's the truth. Yeah, well, I wasn't talking to you there, but... bag fellow says turkeys and apples can restore your life. And what is this like, dear lady? It's exactly that, how you know. Remember for the Order of No Quarter when we weren't afraid to walk around like this? As you can tell by my use of my very opulent dressings as I walk around in public. If I'm gonna run out of health, I gotta get a meal ticket. We're gonna keep going until we run out of the... yeah, well, thank you for that. I'm sure you're telling me that because it would not have been something that I would know at that point. Guess I'm just gonna keep going until I run out of unique character design to talk to. I assume that the ones I already talked to with the same design are gonna say the same things, and apparently the answer is yes. Based on what I'm seeing here. And Spectre Knight, we barely made it out of time. We can't really go into all the houses the same way we can talk to everyone, though. Too bad we don't have a fishing rod. At this time, anyway. Some knights may look down on your choice of weapon, but between us, I dig it, of course. And but a simple bard would have a big problem. I've lost all my music sheets. Well, what do you know? We may have found something that could very well help with that. We have two music sheets. We can get 500 gold for each. Well, as much as I would like to just do that, let me see. I feel like it would be wiser to first come across a place where we can ostensibly spend that money and figure out if we want to be carrying around that much money at this time. We are pretty facetious if we sit often. Well, I'm glad you can appreciate that through this completely face-obscuring helmet. A little bit too short for me, of course. What do you say, first of all, Yotician? Should I extend my magic or health, or just eat a tin can? Why not buy my meal ticket and help narrow my options? Boy, well... how would that... oh, I guess if you... I was... no, I'm still wondering, how would that help narrow his options? Wouldn't it give him more money and potentially expand his options, and then... I don't know if that the implication is that the meal ticket can help you get something that would come in a tin can, but... be doing that right now. Pottage and poultry, mutton and meat, your maximum health will increase if you eat. Bring a meal ticket, I'll whip off a feast. Competition might have some numbers at the side beast. Oh. Okay, never mind. I may have misunderstood what the meal ticket was supposed to imply mechanically at first. Magicist. Or magicist. I don't know. You can increase your maximum magic, but no relics yet. You have to find some relics. Just around the ladder, he always has the weirdest things. Let's see what the people here have to say. Good kid. Nice stick, come on, let's play. You really need Shovel Knight, probably by digging up this dirt. Well, I was gonna do it anyway, but first let's see who else is here. Heavy buckets. What is that Red Knight used to hang out with? Well, we don't talk about that anymore. At least not at this time. Alright, we'll be up the dirt. Yeah, but you know, they really are Shovel Knights. Only a Shovel Knight could have dug up that dirt like so. It takes a very particular technique, you see. Well, I guess we can take a look down here anyway. I don't remember if back when I played the game first, there was like this many people down here. I want to say probably, but like if I can actually recall. Everyone's welcome in here, in the giant winery cellar. Someone could defeat Spectre Knight, I would bestow upon my treasure. King of nothing, not ruled by my law and bar stool. King Knight sits on Pridemore's throne, that gilded goon, he'll get his soon. Double troubled soil and shovel, my third eye knows your useless infos. Excavatio, number of dig piles you've dug is 8. Autum Infiniosa, the amount of gold you've collected is 4949. Which is oddly resonant, but Thanatol Refutatum, number of times you've fallen in battle is 3. Which is more than I kind of expected to have, you know, by the end of the first level, but Temporum Perpetua, the total time you've spent adventuring in this particular, you know, this particular profile disclaimer, is 02152. I'm not a witch, well, at least we do seem to be taking that information in stride. And here's this lady. Most peaceful solitude is too much to ask for as long as I'm stranded here. Shall we pass the time with a little game? Just need 100 gold first, well, maybe in a second, hold on. Hey, I missed a disappointment too, but look, sometimes these things are temporary. Yeah, I'm probably gonna see if I can spend that money on something else first, but I shall return. Shovel Knight, I know things are tough, but don't throw me into trial. Also, watch me expand my bulbous frog chin. Oh, hail the Trouble King, but never heard of the Trouble King. Half trout and half apple, if we're not like mouthful. Well, I believe you. He's one of the forest gods here to help those in need. I'm telling the truth, if you ever visit the sacred Grotto, hold your chalice aloft and the Trouble King will appear. As it happens, I've been entrusted to sell Trouble chalices to believers. Special for storing mythical ichor. I guess we need separate purchases of that. Well, we could afford both, but may not be optimal at this time. You wouldn't believe the merchandise we got for yesterday. Like what? Fishing rod. I probably want this, in fact. Arcane sphere and orb of boundless combat potential. I'm not quite remembering what this does, if anything, but I think the first thing I'm gonna commit to buying is this. I'm pretty sure we're gonna need that for, yeah. Lumber's X, cast into a pit and wait for a bite. Well, it's really pressing square with the controller I'm using right now, but you know. Keep an eye out for sparkly fishing spots. Don't quite remember if that has the same kind of functionality as the, or if the other item that the guy was selling has the same functionality as the fishing rod, which is just to open up the way to items that you just can't get otherwise. Guess I'm gonna get the meal ticket. Visit the astronomer to upgrade your health for 1,000. Sure, we can do that. Do you have any more? Okay, but I can't afford the other one, I see. I'll get to work on my best recipe. That'll be a palate in no time or less, so bon appetit and pardon the mess. I wonder how many people on here actually speak in verse. I'm thinking not that many. I think we've seen like 2 so far who actually do that. Or maybe 3. Because the king and the witch downstairs did that, and this guy does too. Oh, we can do this. I guess if we first collect a relic and then We can increase our magic points, even though I don't even remember to use up magic points to use the fishing rod. I very well might. Well, before we start spending on more stuff, I don't think I'm gonna be spending money on the magic upgrade right now, so let me check. This costs 2500, which would leave me with almost 200, but not quite. I could either get that or the first Trowel, Icor Chalice, which would leave me with more money, but then I'm probably gonna get this first. I did not read the description properly, hold on. Eats options, resume. There we go. Measure for stalling mythical ichor, but probably should have read that description, in fact. Okay, you have to press select again to actually close it again. I believe I can actually afford anything else. That's actually expensive right now, so I guess we'll do this first. I drop some things and you can hit them towards the targets for points. Okay. Oh, goodness. Apparently you can only hit them horizontally, like so. Really much of a strategy to this though, is there? Just like hit them when they're in rage and hope for the best. Seems to be about the one in short of it. You can have to wonder when precisely this is, like how much of a duration this has. Oh, oh. Did fail kind of spectacularly at the, the last bit there. Fit accomplished juggler. Well, I guess we did what we were supposed to. That was kind of ambiguous as to whether that was actually the first case there, but I did get an achievement. Hold on. Got some money back, and yeah, apparently the achievement that I didn't unlock in my previous run of the game, I must assume. Even though that seemed, probably wouldn't take that much, and we just barely don't have enough money to get another one of the chalices, but I don't think I would want another chalice anyway. I don't think I could really afford anything else of import, so it's probably fine. No one can outrun me, though he's like one of the slowest people here. That's probably the joke. I wasn't talking to you, hold on. See, this guy is actually the guy that walks fast, so get a real weapon. I can't believe I ran you down for that. That's rude. Well, what does fucking Pan from Lords of Shadow have to say? Grizzled Seer. Many trials await. You don't despair. Mage defeat strengthen your resolve. Also, the horse in the dress, which I don't believe we've spoken to yet, but it's now gone. Either the fisherman sparkles right from my bottomless pit. That's where the real riches is. I don't know if we really get like a much more different pool of people that walk across the screen over here as opposed to on the left side of town. I guess right now I'm just banking on that horse in a dress character to show up again, because I think that's like the only one that I haven't spoken to, but I don't know how much I can actually expect that to happen. The Red Knight. Digging the shovel. See, how would you dig a shovel though? If you like dig up an old item that was used as a shovel, would that count as digging a shovel? How can you possibly reconcile this paradoxical notion? Fishing. Okay, I guess we haven't talked to that guy either, but yeah, maybe we'll not get. Well, here's a different horse's address. I don't know, look nice in my day off. Well, can only hope that that's the other one that we haven't spoken to yet, but we'll see. Blue jars. I'm pretty sure this is the one that's just rude to you, right? Yeah. It certainly is. Mission is easy. Let's read about fishing real quick, because I was kind of in a hurry. Catch your line, wait for the exclamation mark bubble, which is, you know, always something you can expect when you go fishing. And that's it. Okay, I think probably won't be seeing that character again after all, so let's actually move on. Or wait a minute. Well, let's go to Trouble Plant first. I was gonna say, like, we do have the, you know, music notes that we can sell off and get, like, an extra 1,000, but if we did that, we would still be, like, just barely too short of cash to buy the other thing from the relic guy. Yeah, what's up? There's a Trouble Chalice I can fill with magical Icor. That's pronounced Icor. Yes, that one is actually something I can... What's the fucking word I'm looking for? It's not compel, it's not concede. Either. Comply. That's what I was trying to think of. Choose your Icor wisely. It can be refill health and magic, become invisible for 10 seconds. Absorb nearby treasure. Well, let's go with the one that seems like it'll help us not die like a bitch. As we witness this. You know, the kind of 2D side scroller that, type of game that has a main inspiration, or that this game has as its main inspiration, wouldn't really include something like Link's Awakening, and yet that's like the only thing I can really think of as something that may have been something that specifically inspired this and this character, I suppose. I can only think of the learning Mambo's Mambo scene from Link's Awakening. I think it's just the general sprite work that the big guy has. Also echoes that in my memory. I currently thought I was needed my head again. Well, surely we don't have to watch that every time. Now let's go over to Primar Keepler of King Knight. I'm afraid there won't be any co-op this time, no, I don't think. Probably will be a sharpening of shovel here in the, in this level. And quite probably in a way that won't be very beneficial to me. Boy. And we've actually been to the town and we've seen the stuff that we can spend money on. I do feel that, I probably can't get up here by doing what I'm trying to do right now, but it's probably not even worth it. And I feel like I'm just a lot more... Yeah, just fuck it. Can't screw my attempt to try to get past this without taking damage as well, I suppose, but... Now I'm just being a lot more mindful of, like, hey, yeah, I should probably try to get money. Can we fish here? I do see sparkles, I don't remember. We're supposed to use this. Up an X? Oh yeah, there we go. And we get golden fish, I suppose. I thought there was gonna be like a... Oops. I am failing my own learning process that I'm kind of undergoing. But still, you know, pressing the attack button before I point down, but yeah, no, I thought... For some reason, that there was gonna be like other permanent items that you can get by using the fishing rod. Maybe that will be the case in the future, but that just seemed like a sort of frivolous reward in comparison to what I had in mind. At least, I mean, 350 gold is that much. I will not sneeze at it. It's especially at this point. I basically have nothing, but... And this nothing is exactly the reason why I already ended up buying all that stuff, but I'm extending my life by a whole 1 point. I do get the impression that we do need a lot of money to get all the stuff that matters, at least. Maybe we'll have to do some reruns of some of the stages, which I'm kind of wondering if it comes to that, how that will be handled, but yeah, well, it's not like these stages are terribly long anyhow. Oh, okay, we're just getting ahead. Do I point at this, or am I just being facetious? Can we put the head back on tonight? Probably not. Can we take it with us? Another thing that I'm kind of wondering about, but... Probably no point in doing this, and yet... Must have missed that memo, because here I am. We can do that, and then maybe this way we can get it to go past that little bouncy spot. Let's see if I can get it off the screen at least. No, apparently it will not go off the screen, just... forever... putting up with my abuse, and just... bouncing mercilessly against the edge of this plane of reality. Oh well, whatever. There may be some kind of actual secrets related to that, but... if I know what that might be. Oop, shit. I don't know, having this kind of enemy where you have to, like, wait for him to put his guard down before you attack. It does strike me as a bit more Castlevania-esque, at least in relation to some of the enemies from the Age of Aeneas that came after the classic platformers of the olden days. I'm sure there's the Dead Crusader enemy that's in a few games, that's in at least Aria of Sorrow, and a couple others that came after that one, from what I can remember, that has that same kind of gimmick. Wonder what that means when you consider that, you know, aesthetically at least, the... well, gameplay-wise, really. In both of these senses, the part of Castlevania that serves as an inspiration to this game would definitely be the, more classic arcadey ones. Oh boy. Well, that seemed tricky enough without the boiling oil or whatever it is pouring down our heads, but apparently not quite enough. So I'm here. Now what? Oh, okay. Thought that was taking a moment. Well, if I had a guess based on, you know, the rooms we just went through just a minute ago. These things are probably not going to stay in the air after I step on them. I think I remember blue chests have something in them. Oh boy, in the village around the field I have all the deals, which is why he was trapped in his chest. Well, let's see. Can't do a fiery beast with a flare wand, or fiery blast, excuse me. Fiery beast would be a... need a little overwhelming for the first time. That you find something like this early in the game. Shoots fireballs, but we don't have a whole lot of magic right now. How's our investment working? It's a pretty great relic. Miss it already. I'm just kind of thankful that I have the money for it, because I genuinely do not remember that you can, you know, turn into this guy. Not in town. Though. It's okay. That could have been tragic, but not quite. Oh, wait a minute. Is that how you get up there? Shall we backtrack so we can get a little bit more money? It might be, you know, worthwhile. Just based on the first and so far only foray that we've had to the town, which we were, like, literally 1 gold short of being able to buy a few more useful things. And that may just turn out to be the case, considering that, I guess, the last digit of our gold continues to be 9, for some reason. We get, like, single units of gold in this. I'm not even paying attention to see whether that's the case. I suppose I'm going to assume that the only way to be off the screen is going to be through that, that ladder there. Oh, shit. perhaps this guy is guarding some other passageway. Yeah, there we go. And now the next question, I suppose, will be which of these directions do I actually want to go? Which of these directions will lead? Okay. Forward. And which one will lead to a ostensibly skippable and yet desirable thing? Oh boy. Can't duck or anything, can I? I don't believe I can, like, parry that fireball either. Yeah, there we go. All the extra money is always something that I can also use, I suppose. Okay, so I can go down to there, but what if I don't want to go down to there quite yet? Is there a reason to? I guess not. And I don't think I want to fuck with that sine wave of stuff. So before I proceed, I guess I'll... Oh, fuck. Okay, maybe I will use the medical item that I have. Wait a minute. Am I going to be able to make it back up to that thing? I guess not, but I mean, I already got all the stuff that was over there anyway. I suppose it's not terribly important, unless somehow these, I'm sorry, I'm too distracted, but... Unless these, like, destructible sandblocks, or whatever they are, they're going to show up again once we leave the screen and come back, which they are not. Okay, so we're committed to approaching the same place that we already seen the other way this time. And just not leaving that particular sandblock destroyed. Oh well. Well, let's stick with the sine wave here. See what we can stand to avoid taking damage, and I suppose act based on that. It's okay. Oh, she's kind of casually and very... almost dejectedly kind of swiped, kind of, maybe not dejected, but like... what's the best word to figure out what... to describe what I'm trying to think of here. Oh, fuck. Oh. Okay, that was... a word to describe that could be stupid, but no. The, word I was looking for to describe the, fucking gesture of that griffin as it swiped was more like, I don't know, matter of fact. I really want these things to get too close to the checkpoint here, because I don't want to wreck the checkpoint by accident. The only reason I'm waiting for them to get this close is because I want these little bits of money, because why not, but... oh boy. Might not even be worthwhile. I don't know if I can, probably should have used the other ones that were in, like... that clearly more stable platform over there is guinea pigs, to see if I can jump on them, and apparently I can, there you go. And bounce off them too. But I want to be up here. I guess it doesn't really matter anyway. Maybe I do want to be up there, if, kind of want the stuff down there, but, eh, you know what, we'll... commit to being on this side of things. What? Oh shit, okay. Didn't realize or expect there to be a gap here. Behind these banners. What if it did work out quite nicely for me there? Oh. And then there's this banner where there's a wall instead. Perhaps not on unconquerable wall. At least not encompassing this entire space, but okay, so down here it does seem to be the kind of thing that you can't break. In fact, but not on the top side. Oh well. I'm sure we don't need me to explain that. So okay, there is no way to like go down the stairs or anything. That does kind of lead me to wonder, where do we go? Can we just, like, go back the same way we came? Can't get up there for that. There doesn't seem to be a way to, you know, leave the screen through this side of it. So do we in fact just go back the way we came? It's okay, I guess so. I was committing to something, but no, I can just return. Without consequence, and I did not realize you could bounce the, you know, the beetles and probably other, probably other enemies as well. You can probably get more money or something if you do that enough. Much like you can farm, you know, lives that way in, like, Mario and what have you, but... I'll be grabbing this. I will be, making an attempt, I suppose, to, that apparently succeed quite nicely. Not after, unfortunately, taking damage from that very obvious trap. Oops. Oh shit, it actually crossed that gap. I did not expect that. For some reason, even though it makes a lot of sense. Oh shit. Discovered this by accident, but it was quite a happy accident, at least. I'll go around. I don't think I want to, like, jump straight into him here. There we go. Probably taking that extra 100. Quite gladly. Thank you very much. Ooh. Maybe, possibly, potentially. Oh boy. Yep. Loading time, I suppose. It seems so weird when it happens in this game. I'm gonna check out what's over here, because this does seem like it will unambiguously be the, you know, the extra path. Oh, there goes the helmet that time, which was just lost to the abyss, unambiguously. Oh. Pretty sure I'm gonna want to, get rid of those fucking mice, rats, whatever they are. Before I try to collect all of this stuff the proper way. And there we go. Gee, I wonder how much I'm gonna be able to afford once I'm back in town. All this money. Let's see here. I think there's actually a gap between. Yeah, where you stand and where the anchor comes out whenever you. A Fortnite I've been gift from the Trowel King. Oh boy, but you can't carry anymore. Oh well, that's a shame. Yeah, maybe we should have some extra chalices, but I mean, we haven't used the first chalice at all, so I get the feeling that even if we did have that. Oh boy. Oh, damn it. What if we had, you know, the second chalice, if we had bought that, still would not have, you know, used any of them, so. We'll need a refill there, regardless. Oh, shit. What if we can renew the... Okay, yeah, we can. I was wondering about that. Renew the timer for those things. Oh, boy. Oh, shit. Oh, very, very unfortunate timing from the fucking cauldrons there, but... Apparently, if you hit these things repeatedly, you can, in fact, we also got the other note thingy, right? I trust. I don't think you have to, like, recollect them if you, die, and then... don't make it to another checkpoint in the meantime. I mean, it's not there anymore. It would be visible there if it, was still there, and it's not, so... Let's try that again. And this time, try to not die horribly. So we'll wait a little bit longer to, Fuck. To die, I suppose. We just lost a good chunk of money, I'm pretty sure. I guess I can probably outrun that rat, at least. Gonna have to wait around and wait for it to be killed by me. I don't think I'm gonna get that bag of money back. Very unfortunate, but oh well. What are you really gonna do? I'm just gonna lose more money if I try to get that back. Gee, I wonder what all this could mean, getting a bunch of health back. Surely nothing of import will be on this next screen. Lackadaisical? Could that be a word to describe the, you know, the other utter apathy of this? I guess that could be another one. Just go to a very basic term, apathetic. The utter apathy of the griffin as it swipes at you. Like, whatever. I guess we'll do this. Surely this will solve all my problems immediately. Interlopers in our midst, begun from our throne room, knave. No more intruder than you, you aren't even a real king. But you're mistaken, the enchantress saw before my fabulously regal self and now all bow before me. You're not but a decadent dandy. Prepared to taste justice. Shovel justice. That doesn't even sound like anything. That would be, sound like and actually make sense of that, but I will be making this work somehow. Figure out how I can invest. Do this. Yeah, no, I'm pretty sure that I can just probably just DPS race this battle. Considering how, well, if I'm a little less, this is reminding me of another certain trope that you see a good amount in, you know, the game set inspired by this kind of. Or the kind of game that inspired this game. Which is, you know, being just barely out of horizontal reach, attack reach of the enemy. When you try to attack. Definitely seen that in a few other games, but I mean, I don't know, now that I'm thinking about it more, I don't know if how much I've seen that in games that are older than this, and how much I've seen that in games that are, you know, like this, more modern indie stuff, with that same kind of style. Well, we do have 5,000 plus money now. So I think one other game that comes to mind when I think about stuff like that would be like Bloodstained Curse of the Moon. And maybe even Ritual of the Night of that. And then again, maybe again, some like Castlevania's where you don't use the whip. I don't know how many of those there were. In the classic description, Persuasion, like the only example that I can think of off the top is playing as Eric Lacard in Bloodlines, but if you do that, I'm pretty sure you're not gonna be wanting for horizontal reach, because that spear is very long. There's also like Maria in Rondo of Blood, but I don't think that reach is an issue with her either. With the bird and all the extra stuff she has. So probably not classic Castlevania anyway, but then you got the Megavadius where you got like a much wider selection of weapons that you can use. So hold on, where did I come here? What do I actually want to spend money on first? Okay, has the Chaos Sphere, which I'm still not quite sure what it does, honestly. Well, if it did beat up King Knight, so I wonder what this guy has to say. King Knight wins no more, huzzah. Now I can rule Pride more, hurrah. Can't wait to greet old Plume and Beaky, they probably can't wait to see me. Oh boy, I suppose that's supposed to be the very apathetic griffins we killed. Which kind of makes me wonder if it would be at all possible to, like, get past them without killing them, but who knows. A king knight who gave him an inch, he thinks he's a ruler. I guess we could do the, you know, the trouble chalice. Doesn't cost, yeah, it doesn't cost magic to use this thing, I guess. I'm kind of thinking that maybe I'll get that, that thing, that orb. Pretty sure I'm gonna wanna do that at some point regardless. Could get the other, you know, Icor vessel. Or we could get whatever it is that we, can get here, the mule ticket. I think it costs like 3,500, like we won't even be able to, 4,500, okay, enough. We definitely won't be able to afford anything else if we get that right now. Maybe we could just commit to that and, like, stop thinking about what exactly I'm gonna have to do. Oh, but then again, there's this guy. 4 music sheets, so we could get an extra 2,000 this way. And if we did that, we would have 2,500 left over, so I guess we could get those two things, get the health upgrade and the orb, and that probably would be, yeah, let's do that. I'll buy the mule ticket and see how much the next one costs, presumably. 6,000, okay, it doesn't seem like it was as much of a drastic increase as the previous one, but still. That is an extra 6,000 on top of what we've already spent. Looks like raw fish, the inside of whatever that thing is, but there we go. Found spinny bottle. Client's only reaction was, oh, it's okay, I guess, whatever. Was it not broody enough for you? Now that I have this music sheet, I can perform it for you at any time. Well, what would you like to hear? Well, what do we have? Main theme, steal thy shovel, one fateful night. Not decisive blue. Spinny bottle. Oh boy. It's really tough to fight those bottles with only a boot. Is that like the minigame theme that we played just a little while ago? That we have to pay 100 to play? Quite possibly. Arrival. No, yeah, that's the actual Black Knight theme. That's a patch, take it and dandy. A total of 46 by the looks of it. And, okay, we can move back around. No advance here, main theme, steal thy shovel. Of course, the next question is, will this keep playing, even if they're, after both we, yeah, stop talking to him and leave the screen? And apparently the answer is yes, so let's just do the other thing that I was going to do with this money, and be left with as little money as possible, probably a good idea. We're going into, another heretofore unexplored. Oh shit, I didn't read the description for that either. All this combat potential, what does it mean? It just bounces. So when they say that it's boundless, that's a bit of a, you know, misnomer. When bound is exactly what it does. Can't believe there's no pile of gems hidden underneath that particular dirt, though. It's quite disappointing, but oh well. And then there's, well, you know, for some reason it didn't occur to me to mention this until now, that I'll point out the probably quite obvious fact to those who know that the enemy on the overworld is from Mario 3. But I don't know how much I would really say that Mario specifically was an influence to this game. Well, let's go to the enemy anyway and see what exactly we're gonna see. Well, maybe also a little bit just the specific kind of graphic that the enemy has, where it's like a figure, a silhouette. Kind of sort of facing you, instead of being sided. How do I even describe this? Like a profile figure, like in Mario 3. Instead of just kind of like silhouette that's facing the camera, which makes it seem more like the, oh fuck it, the overworld encounters in Zelda 2, which may also be what these mini stages are supposed to be like. If I call back to. Oh shit. Just kill yourselves. I'll be the tickets. Oh shit. It occurs to me that I don't actually need these freaking dragons to bridge these gaps. Just make it a little more convenient, but I can just, you know, destroy these sand piles and just do it that way. Taking that back, I'll be taking this for the first time. I'll be popping you into the abyss, maybe, or just watch as you bounce back from the abyss. Oh well. There we go. Let's do Lich Yard. Take on Spectre Knight, perhaps. It's shoveling time. I did not remember if, and I still do not remember, quite frankly, if, like, at the beginning of each stage, you get, like, a different shovel-themed one-liner. Oh, shit. Oh, wait a minute. Does that hurt you if you walk into it? No, it doesn't. That's good. It's just to support you. That's what I want to hear. Got these frogs. Honestly, they remind me not just of, like, Fleeman from... Castlevania, which might be the intention, or, you know, just like, also remind me of the literal, you know, frog and toad enemies from Castlevania, which are in, like, Castlevania 4 and Rondo of Blood and Chronicles and whatnot. They also remind me of, like, some of the enemies that you fight in fucking Getsufuma Den, oddly enough. It definitely makes me question, like, how much of the, how much any one of these games was, like, a specific inspiration for this game with... get to the point of abstraction and, like, the similarity between some of those games and this game isn't because of actual inspiration, but just because of the general conventions of the genre. Oh shit. I guess we need these hideaway to uncover some of these hidden... Oh fuck, patch this. And now these guys are like the Yorick enemies from, wait a minute. Shit. Okay, I was wondering if bouncing off of that thing would help me reach up there, because I figured I couldn't do it just by jumping normally. Which sucks, although I guess I should have planned for that sooner, but I didn't. Oh. And now that guy's over there, and not over here. I'm gonna leave the screen and... oh, wait a minute, we can't actually... Shit. Okay, there we go. We can still get this, at least. Even if it seems we may not be long for this world if I keep up this get-hit-every-2-seconds thing. I'm just kind of wondering if, how miserable some of this stuff may or may not be. I can't get up here by bouncing up the... yeah, okay, the graves. And these ghosties, they don't die, do they? It's just like... become temporarily aggravated. Oh wait, there's something here. Is there a way to go here? No, it's not. There is not, rather. God, I've only played Getsufuma Den once. I did it this year, I'm pretty sure, just a few months ago. And yet... for some reason, I'm having a really hard time. Well, not for some reason, I mean, I played it once, like I said. I'm pretty sure I did it all in one sitting, too. It's a pretty short game. Seems like an easy way to do it. And we even get all our health back, which is nice. But I don't remember, like, what... I'm pretty sure there was, like, some special things about, you know, the way that game is designed. I'm pretty sure I'm being reminded of by some of the stuff in this game. Even now, but... I'm totally blanking on being any more specific than that. That's a good sign. Something that I've noticed about the frog enemies here too is that I guess be more safe to fight them if you bounce on them versus trying to like hit them with your shovel horizontally. Because I guess when you do the latter, that's when they do their like weird kind of lightning aura move. I don't know, are frogs known for other than, I don't know, dissecting frogs? Other than Tim Burton's Frankenweenie, are they known for being particularly associated with electricity? Lightning? Ooh, okay, well, we'll have fun with that. Is there like some kind of electric frog deity in some kind of world culture that I'm not aware of? If not, then I would like to, you know, claim precedence to that idea, because that sounds like it could be kind of badass, but... Oh boy. A bit of a double team going on here. So I need to explore all the side routes, because I keep thinking, no, there's definitely gonna be, like, you know... I'm gonna be like, okay, let me guess. I can get up all the way up there if I do this. Yep. There's definitely gonna be like, you know, something I actually want to get from this one over here. Like, please. You know, a note or something. There is a note here. Oh boy. This is scary. Like, straight up. I'm just saying that to be facetious. Well, because it's, you know, thematically appropriate for the stage. It's very much the kind of thing that I'm pretty sure would have me, oh fuck. Okay. I thought for some reason I was gonna need that to, need to do that to... Oh, here we go. Yeah, I can't even finish that sentence because this shit is moving super quickly. Need to bounce on that grave to get to the end of the level, but or the screen, I mean. Apparently not. Oh boy. Okay, my question here will be if I try to use the fishing rod from all the way up here, will it work? The answer is yes. Okay. Why not? Yeah, I can't carry anymore, I guess. I should probably be using these fucking icro chalices a lot more liberally than I am right now. Okay, this could be bad. I'm gonna do that and then let you... I was gonna say, hopefully spike yourself, you know, on the ceiling there, but I guess that's not gonna be, you know, the game's not gonna be that good to me. Oh boy. I don't even know why I'm, you know, letting myself get this low on the platform. Doesn't seem like it's necessary to be able to make it. I don't even want to hit these spikes, but I guess I can't. Can I get that blue gem even if I do hit it with my shovel? That's unfortunate. Oh shit. This could be a problem as well. Or maybe not. Oh boy. I guess I want this frog to help me get down here. At least for a second. Oh my god. Can you stop? Stop for a moment, you know, in a place where your position is actually favorable to me. It would be fantastic. Apparently, no, the frog cannot stop for a moment to do that. Okay. Just notice that there's a fucking skull over here that I can probably use for exactly this same purpose. There we go. Just trying to fucking rodeo the frog for no reason. Now the question is why it's down there, and... How badly do I want it, hopefully? Well, since I'm already over here, I guess I might as well see what's in this direction. It does seem like this is gonna be the, probably the harder part of it to access, though. So is it Chester again? It is Chester again. Why did you just find it here? Face logger exchange from all harm briefly, though. It doesn't seem that expensive, so sure, whatever. You can even walk on what? Sprinkles? Sparkles? I'm guessing that's hit sparkles. And that also, again, seems like the kind of thing that, boy. That would enable us to get some items that would be impossible to get otherwise, but much like I suppose I've been sort of retroactively surprised with the effects of the fishing rod and how not actually that useful it's been. Actually, hold on a minute. Speaking of that, hold on. I was gonna say try to get to relative safety so I can heal with the fucking Igor, but then that just happened. Completely unfavorable stuff, and then this. Well, at least now we know that there's gonna be, you know, bombing here, so we can just bait all these guys into killing themselves for me. Walking into their own demise, we don't need to go back to the left now. I don't want to find out what happens if we, get smooshed between those two platforms, either. Oh, shit. How dare you come here? I just feel compelled to, you know, run through this as quickly as possible, just because I don't want to spend more time on this screen that I already went through. At least the fact that you can't recollect all the money does help with that, and now we can probably avoid losing tons of health back to this stupid frog a second time. We can still lose some amount to, some very unfortunate circumstances, but could have been worse. That is the way to look at it. Okay. Is this health? This is also health, so you know, there was also health on this screen, so I didn't even need to use my Igor. And there's a thing right after it. Like one bit of insult to injury after another. Okay, I can go. This apparently is not gonna get any higher, so let's see if I can even reach that platform there from over here without having to increase that height. Actually, I sure hope this doesn't go straight into the hole and get lost. No. Oh, I suppose not. Oh god. It does seem like that goes dangerously close to approximating you to the edge of the bottom edge of the screen, though. Guessing that not much goodness happens if that actually occurs. Oh boy, let's get back. Why is this guy back? Her skull has been cast into abyss, into the abyss twice over now. Oh, I didn't end up using the, oh boy. Wait a minute. I'm gonna try to do it from over here. So I was gonna say, does it look like you kind of have to use the fishing rod from the edge of the platform that sinks? That doesn't make any sense, but maybe we can do it from here. I'm about to find out at any rate. It does look like that does, in fact, match up. I already found, like, a, you know, refill fish, so I guess this time we're getting a money fish. I wonder if there's a way to break this wall, blocking access to the stuff from over here, or if, oh, we can't bounce on the ghost. I was actually wondering, oh shit, about that too, but at least we don't want to bother too much with the little fucking magic vials around these screens. Grabbing all this, because it does seem like a way to get back up or to, if we fell through the floor on one of these, it's probably gonna be more of that going on, hopefully. I seem to... Oh, God. Okay, I guess this guy's back. He's gonna give us money again if we kill him again. Nope, just gonna give me that and more POs at least. That I will gladly take. Can we fall through any of these? No, I guess not. Okay, that does kind of leave me puzzled as to how exactly we're meant to get those jewels that are like up there. But then again, maybe, well, there's that, you know, oh fuck, I don't want to break that thing. Bouncy plant thing that you're supposed to hit up upward. Hit upward, which probably should not have the same connotation as hit up. If someone tells you to hit them up and you end up hitting them upward like that, that's probably not the intended consequence of that request. Imitation. Whatever you may want to call it. Okay, we are on the platform, which I couldn't see very clearly, but ah shit. Definitely reluctant to take the plunge here. Either way. It does seem like these guys, these green skeletons that I guess we have up ahead. Do we die in one hit, which is definitely favorable to my sensibilities here. Oh boy. Okay, this is spooky too. What the fuck, this platform that we can't see. Okay. Are sinking and you can't even like properly tell. I'll be grabbing that. I don't know if there's like anything other than those that like group of gems I saw on that one screen that I missed. But I presume we're at the end here. With the not death from Castlevania specific reference boss fight slash character. That does in fact have its own game mode, so it is no place for the living mortal. You shall be summoned when it is your time and you will come to this specific location. Everyone has a time, as we saw with your beloved Shield Knight. I won't believe such talk from phantoms. Your very existence is a vile deception. The Enchantress is just full of surprises. She granted me new life after I was killed, I suppose. So that I may take yours. Okay, I'm not successfully, you know, reacting upon this pattern the way that I should. Thus far. Oh, okay. Then again, I don't think I can be expected to remember any of the boss patterns after the time that it's been, I dare say. I can try, that's for certain. Try to just process them as they come, and I don't believe I can really try to do much else at this point, at this time, under these circumstances. Oh boy, what? What was that attack, by the way? Was it like the lightning bolt in Mario Kart? I'm not sure what the effect there was properly. Yes, the skeletons that were on the field went away, but why exactly did that happen? Oh boy, probably not going in that direction. It does seem like you can, you know, bounce on top of him when he does the, that particular charge, the very resolute charge, but I suppose I've not been very, very successful in that sense so far. Basically, I'll probably get my money back. Is there like a dog howling outside, by the way? I feel like I can't hear that very clearly. Maybe not howling, like, full-on howling, but maybe barking. In lamentation because some fuckhead will not let the dog out of its wherever they keep it. Which is never a nice thing to see. Like right here, can I bounce on him? Yes I can, okay. Just need to go quite far in that direction, horizontally. Oh shit, yeah. Not do it in that way. That's a particular attack. I probably got it down well enough now. This is like any other huge surprises that in this sort of boss behavior that we've not seen until now. Okay, so I guess when he does that big flesh thing, it's literally just killing the skeletons and that's it. That is all that happens. Oh shit. Okay, that I was not expecting to fall on the platform that time. Oh, and now it's dark. Okay, I guess that could be the other big surprise. Which I probably should have seen coming, and yet I did not at that time, anyway. But hey, all the more reason for me to believe that there won't be any other major changes in the pattern at this point. Unless you like... Oh, okay, so all we have to go on to at this point, now that it's dark, to tell that he did that attack where he's gonna charge at you very quickly, is the sound. But fortunately, that is exactly what we used to prevail in that occasion. Oh, we got a chest this time. Can we, no, I guess we can't. I'm just gonna go to sweep again. Oh boy, hold on, it's better not to put my controller down. For doing this again. I don't know if this affects anything, but, you know, might as well go through the motions of being like, yeah. Oh, shit. We can get more money, I guess. I don't know if we're gonna be able to, like, really keep this money when we... Well, it's taking a really long time to calm down, at least there's that. But she was nice enough to come down, you know, right at the spot where we were right then. I don't know what we're burning in the bonfire to just be able to dig it up and find a bunch of gems, or why we just put this meal ticket in the chest and put it next to ourselves while we sleep, when we presumably keep the rest of our stuff in a different sort of ephemeral inventory. That's not separate from our person, question mark, in other occasions, but... Oh boy. What options do we have right now? Do we have Iron Whale, Lord of Treasure Knight, Exploratorium, Lord of Plague Knight, and other places we can... And, well, basically, it's Lost City, Lord of Mole Knight, and that airship city-looking place where we can't reach until we've been at least one of the other... new bosses, three new bosses that we've got access to now. I'm thinking we'll do Plague Knight first, but first, let's see, Muddler's Quarry. I think I'm gonna go to the town first and see if I can't spend money on this. Of course, I want to go to this gem on the world map first. Oh shit, I wasn't expecting this. Hopefully I don't lose money if I die here and do horribly. I guess we're seeing some kind of speaking of ephemeral. Some kind of pride more keep of that same persuasion where it's auto-scrolling, which, yeah, there's gonna be so much stuff in this game that I just don't remember at all from my one and only preceding run of it. That ought not to be surprising. Okay. Come on. Can I at least dig up one of these? Get at least a little bit of that money from it. Okay, well, we can get the money that was in between these two things, but I guess I can't break the sand things themselves. Oh well. Well, I didn't die, so I would like to call this a success in a technical fashion, at the very least. And presumably some of these other stages with the gem design on it, forest facing, and what's the other one? Nuclear Scoring, which we already looked at. Okay. You know how bad my memory is. Presumably they also have the main function of getting us more money, but well, let's see what we can use our money for right now. In fact, we have two music sheets in stock. I wonder if we're ever gonna see that other horse in a dress ever again. Does this guy sell new things now? He probably does, since we've, you know, changed the world map each. No, apparently that's not the case after all. Okay, I'm guessing though, if you can't afford the stuff that he sells, you When you're in the field, he probably brings it back here and sells it here. So let's see. With that in mind, what are our options right now? We can get another chalice, which it looks like there is only one more available right now. Oh yeah, and defeated Spectre Knight, now behold my greatest treasure, Knight. Or dance. I am very good at parsing words, as you can tell. This is also another sign of tiredness. Or the probable reason why I'll probably only do one more stage and leave it at that for now, but... I will say I don't really remember. Didn't really remember what prompted this. I did remember this dance being a thing, but... Can't say I really remembered what, you know, caused it to occur. Is the answer is defeating Spectre Knight. So these guys are presumably just gonna keep saying the same thing, though. Dancers, acolytes, witches, goats. Hmm. Well, which one's the acolyte, though? Is it the Trouble King acolyte, specifically? The one that's totally not a witch, and the goat who's not even in this room. Or in this underground area. I'm thinking what we'll end up spending the money on right now is I'll just get another health extension, and... Actually, we have two health extensions right now, don't we? I'm all out now. I had more, but they became meals before I had arrived. Although we can get that. Two meal tickets. We'll get, I guess, two dishes at once. And we'll spend the, well, a chunk of our remaining money, at least, on... Okay, that was a different design for the thing, at least. What the fuck am I looking at? Blood sausage? But yeah, we'll spend most of the remainder of our money on the other trouble chalice, I suppose. It's pretty much all we can do right now. But well, we can also, you know, upgrade the magic, but I feel like I'm not really gonna be using the magic a whole lot. Trouble King, etc. And... Yeah, I suppose there's also technically the magic as something that I could spend money on, but I would rather hang on to it for now. I get the feeling that that will be more advisable right now, anyhow. If I go in here, can I... No, I guess it autosaves, so it's not like a manual save option. Well, speaking of that, I guess we'll check out these stages and then probably do the Exploratorium, and that's probably where I'll leave it off, question mark, if I can even, do these stages right now. Maybe I can't. Well, I could face away to safety, I could cross and get so much treasure, Set up. Yeah, okay. Okay. Let's do that. Oh, wait a minute. I did it twice. I don't know how much it really lasts. It's use. From all harm briefly. The flat one is what we have. Okay, well. Okay. That's all that you get from that. I am wondering if it would be worth, if it's gonna be worthwhile to get on that, try to get on that sand platform up there. Well, let's do the thing. Okay. I believe we can make it anyway. There we go. We can get a tiny, tiny pittance of money by breaking this thing. What else? Oh boy. Oh shit. Okay, so I guess we're, that's why we have to face her. The only way to escape. Knockback-induced death, which, you know, that definitely does seem like it falls in line quite well with some old-school platformers where you have stupid deaths because of mechanics like that. Let me just wait for this slime to kill itself and then we can carry on our merry way. And now I shall do this. Oh, you better not do exactly that again. God damn it. Well, at least I see that I picked a quite fitting name for this profile. I could also make some kind of joke about, you know, being blue hoped. Dabba dee dabba die, or something like that, but. Surely that's already been thought up in quite a few contexts, but I could be the first one, potentially, to bring that up in this very specific context. in which, that is to say, specific in the sense that it's me, the individual, that it's me playing this game. And I suppose now I have even more of a reason to try and wait for the fucking slime to kill itself before I even move an inch on that screen. I think that also confirms something that I had suspected, but not quite verified, I don't think, which is that spikes do in fact kill you instantly. I don't think we're going to be able to get that one back, unfortunately. And there's literally nothing that we get from doing that right now, so... Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay, I guess we're going to have to forcibly make a pit stop on that second platform just so we can reactivate the facing. I didn't remember to wait for the slime, but I guess it didn't make a huge difference that time. I'll be doing this, I'll be waiting for this to run out, and then I'll activate it again, because apparently that's the only way this is gonna work. Go figure. Oh boy. Hold on. Okay, so I can do this, and that's how we can... Could be daring and try to... I think I'll do that. There we go, get in this hole. Without facing. Oh, for fuck's sake. And then probably fail. I'm quite sure that I, you know, activated the thing again before I stepped out left that last time, but apparently that was not how some parts of the universe read it. I don't know. Probably need to take a drink of water. Can't really do that at this precise moment. I did not remember, though, that you were going to get knocked back by hitting the slime. Okay, need to be mindful of that damn slime now. Oh, also get this. Even though I don't think it makes a difference at this point. Okay, let me just prostrate myself right here and then wait a couple hours for the slime to slide off, and then that stupid factor is out of the way. This reminds me a little bit of Haunted Castle, the fucking, you know, Castlevania arcade game at this point, just because of how... There. Okay, at least we can pull that off. Oh, well, this is gonna be interesting. Pretty sure we can reactivate that while it's already running, at least, so that should be... That should be not a problem. Well, now what are we gonna do? And what if we get these loading screens, like... This is something that I could be fairly confident in swearing I just did not, fuck, experience when I first ran through this game. No Windows update, you can just rot there forever, I don't care. I don't know what it says that even though we're failing so hard so repeatedly, we're still technically making a sort of net gain in this stage. Well, I guess I'll take this time to tell this stupid Windows update notification to go away. There we go. It's not gonna happen. Okay. I'm going to do this in a very specific fashion. You know, it's not good enough to do it in a sensible fashion. You need to do it in a dedicated fashion. I don't know if you can do it in midair. I'd rather not risk that right now. No way they give you, like, well, probably so, just so you can... Ah, do the thing again, anyway. I'm pretty sure the first time I was on this screen just a minute ago, I reactivated the thing or tried to immediately upon hitting that platform, and yet it didn't quite work. Hold on. I'm guessing that we have to activate it here just so we can, you know, do this. And maybe I finally made it to the end, that would be quite nice. And it disappeared, that's probably the implication here, so... I didn't get a whole lot of, profit out of that. Owing to my own incompetence, but at least we got it out of the way. And, I do feel paranoid enough that I want to... absolutely spend as much money as I can... if before I go into the other one of these. So yeah, I think we'll do the other one of those stages. How much does it cost now, by the way? 2200, that's not too bad, in fact. It's definitely, it seems like there's an increase in cost compared to what it was like on the other one. The food health upgrades. Oh yeah, hold on a minute, do we have the no, never mind. I'm gonna see if we have the two Icor chalices filled up, but the answer is no. Okay, let's just go ahead and, you know, come over here and fill it. Maybe we have the same one. I don't really see any reason to pick any of the other ones right now. And let us just make a beeline for this other stage, the Knuckler's Quarry. Which is another one that I'm not even sure if we can complete right now, to be honest with you. There's no way to punch through. Just that for there. Okay, never mind. So we can't even do this one right now, because I'm pretty sure we need another one of these. Then there are relics that you can get in the one of the other levels. We need a tiny, tiny amount of money, I suppose. Yeah, these little, like, silver nuggets or whatever they are. They are worth precisely 1 gold to appear. Return everything to the state. Oh, including the amount of gold that I have, presumably. Yeah. Just surrender. Okay, let's do the exploratorium and then probably call it a night. If you know what I mean. Strike the earth. It didn't say that at the very start of the game, I'm pretty sure, but now it does. Sure what to expect there. Oh, for... Okay. Not only are these beetles immune to the fire, but they don't even trigger it. Oh, okay. Do they... Do the Sphinx jump on the when they... Probably, yes. When they are approaching you, I would imagine. Is there a reason to do all this? Apparently not. Well. Oh, okay. The thing that I do not remember is these rats blowing up these blocks when they blow themselves up upon death. They find themselves in the same predicament. Oh boy. I would say that this is one of those stages that's probably kind of touted as being more of a specific callback to Castlevania than most, and yet... I don't know how much I'm really gonna be able to agree with that. I mean, these birds that are dropping the potions up here, I suppose they're supposed to be like the ocean. The eels that drop Fleeman on you in Castlevania, they're... First seen in Castlevania 1 doing that. And then they show up in a couple of other games after that doing the same thing. Oh wait, we got like some fishy stuff in here, hold on. Gotta keep an eye out for that, I guess. There's always a possibility that it could be money. And this time it is in fact money, which... I suppose at least at this point in the stage I can definitely value more than the health Icor refill. Oh, shit. Okay, this could be inconvenient, I would say. There. That out of the way, at least. And I believe we do have to come over here and stand on this platform just so we can be high enough to make this jump, and oh god, I don't know why I did that. Force of habit, I suppose. Force of habit on other things in this game, though. I don't know what other things altogether, but some things certainly. Presumably we have to go here first, or else we can get locked out of that route. Okay. I wonder if I already got locked, like, I think in the graveyard I already may have been gotten locked out of a route, at least. I got a bit of a leap of faith, but And I was like, I believe it was in the graveyard. Yeah, but I saw one screen where... That one screen where there was, like, gems in the corner and couldn't reach them. Presumably there was another way, but I'm not really sure about it if that other way also may have included another more concrete item, less fugacious item, like... Oh, fuck. Like, perhaps a note or another relic. I hope not. But... really couldn't say at this point. Oh boy. I see that this guy, the way that he attacks, could also potentially be another Castlevania callback, but I couldn't even tell you what it is right now. Maybe just like axe armors. I don't even remember right off the bat if the axe armors attack like that. Or if there, what I mean is if there are axe hammers that attack like that by throwing stuff in the, I guess more like the skeletons that throw the bones in an arc, because the axe hammers are more like, they throw their axes like a boomerang most of the time. What the fuck is that thing? Is that supposed to be like a Kirby enemy kind of reference? Enemy, way that it becomes kind of unsettlingly. Unsettling the closer it gets to you, kind of like the Scarface. That's like the first thing that comes to mind when I think of stuff to compare it to. So maybe that is in fact a ticket, who knows. Probably not me right now. Oh fuck. Well, at least these spikes haven't killed you instantly. That's always nice. Oh boy. At least they can be killed kind of in a very straightforward fashion, unlike the Scarface. They've got that difference going for them. Oh boy. That is going to be the, I guess, this safest way to try and not get spiked. I'm trying to make that jump, oh boy. And I'm guessing that we missed some monies over there because we killed those things quickly and didn't realize that could have bounced off them to get up there. Oh well. You know, hopefully there's not a fucking page hidden in the fucking sandblocks up there. That would really be the shit. I'll be grabbing this, or at least trying to. Try to make it up there, and I guess that shows that, I suppose, oh boy. Okay, now we can make it up there. Bouncing on those things and trying to go straight down. It's probably not a good idea if they can, yeah. Shit. It's very inconvenient. These fucking slimes, they don't stay on the platforms, I know that much. Oh fuck, okay, almost died there. Well, at least pleased that I didn't. Oh god, I didn't. I'm not pleased, however, that I... Oh my god, really? Hold on. Can I salvage this? Probably not. Oh, well, I almost managed, but then the bird was too fast. Well, at least now we get another chance. The question is if that chance will really be... that chance is something I'm really gonna be able to exploit for what I want. I wonder if I have to bounce on the bird itself or if that's like condemned. I do like it when my enemies to eliminate themselves, so I want to get rid of this awkward platform situation. Oh shit. For some reason I didn't expect my own shovel bouncing downwards to... Oh, okay, just barely made it to, break those platforms, even though that makes a full amount of sense, I would say. One further consideration. Now, what about these grain blocks? Okay, they have, like, extra health. I suppose that's it. Well, that's at least something good to keep in mind. Definitely quite thankful for the notion that you don't have limited lives, though. That's for certain. Oh boy. She's gonna wait for you over here. And I wanna say that this... My god. Maybe these, you know, various parts of this game are kind of making me think of various parts of other classic platformers from the 8-bit era. I want to see that this boss encounter in particular is making me think of like something from a boss encounter from Castlevania 3, even if, once again, I couldn't really tell you exactly what that meant. Which boss encounter am I talking about? Even I don't even know. I certainly will not know. So I'm just not coming up with anything concrete to you know, finish that sentence with, that analogy with comparison. That notion. Oh, this is gonna go on for a while, I have to wonder. Oh, there we go. How many repeater rounds of spooky embryo, but 8-bit encounters can we have? Yeah, I like the, In fact, if there's one thing that, you know, must be brought back from those classic platformers of this game that I like, it's the fact that we can just stand on one foot of the other platform and definitely still be able to stand properly that way. Okay. I love endurance there, I guess. I'm trying to use my own spells against me. Let me know this. A carrot, I'll take that. Oh boy, this is gonna be interesting. Oh, probably did that too early, but at least the bouncing is just tight enough to bounce you back exactly to the platform you were just on, but apparently that still did not make a difference as to my own ability to survive. Oh, wait a minute, this is like, yeah. A fishing spot here that I did not notice at all before. Is it gonna be something worthwhile, or is it gonna be like a Icor refill, which we don't need right now? Oh shit. Oh, I failed to actually react. I forgot you have to you know, press the button one more time. It's an Icor refill. What do you know? That's unfortunate. I'll stand here on one foot while keeping this perfectly upright posture, and nobody will question because it is not your place to do that. Fuck, I kinda wish... yeah. Kinda wish that wasn't that fucking 9 encounter was not on a platform like that. Get to solid ground before we get fucking harassed by these things. At least we got full health back at something. This reminds me a little bit of fucking fuck Castlevania the Adventure. The upright things that you climb on. Oh boy, what are we loading this time? Shovel Knight, I suppose. Can't believe Luigi's Mansion 3 ripped this off. And also, you know, Castlevania 3, because I'm pretty sure the doppelganger boss in that game is pretty much just like purple goo that just transforms into whatever character you have at the time. And it's one of those kind of pain in the ass bosses that's very much advised to just should cheese it. With the exemplary version of the... Wait, what? Okay, how did that not work? Oh, whatever. Oh, I suppose I should have seen that coming. just throw yourself down the pit. That is exactly what I want you to do. Thank you. That is very favorable for me. Thank you for your cooperation in this and all things. Oh god. Well, this is gonna be interesting. I think that definitely does strike me as something that I just don't like so far, though. It's just the fact that just hitting some of these enemies makes you, the player, get knocked back. Seems like terribly inconvenient, but, well, let's see. Could it be that we're up to the boss, I wonder? Or do we get a... No, I think we are up to the boss. I was gonna say, do we get something a little bit more to go on, but I suppose not. Leave me alone, show yourself, Plague Knight, your trickery will not stop. The fruits of my research are no mere trick. Boom. Let's have a lesson, shall we? I promise it'll be enlightening and also formulating and other, you know, fire and explosion-related words that don't actually work as poetic analogies. Because nobody uses them like that. Okay, wait, it's only some of these. It feels like some of these, yeah. Explosives, I think, froze. Create like the little green flames that run along the ground as a follow-up. Oh, for fuck's sake. Looks like we just got the good old DPS race to depend on here. Hold on, let me see if I can use this. Take it again. Let's just cheese it. Oh, fuck not. I feel like I have to lose some money just to have to redo that, so... I will gain that money instead, even if I'm not even sure what I will be using it for at this point. Also, we did not get the relic that lets us punch through the rows of dirt blocks, but I'm pretty sure that's just because that wasn't... That was very clearly not the stage that corresponded to being able to get that relic in the first place. So it's not terribly surprising. Have to leave that bonus stage for later. But in that very self-same sense, well, I guess we can check out this town that we weren't able to get to before, but I guess after clearing any of the bosses in this area, we can actually do that. I'm fairly sure it's Mole Knight stage that we have to do. Get that ability, but I don't even know. Our scouts are approaching, we know your quest. This is the armor outpost. But you are holed up here deep in enemy territory, it's dangerous. Get whipped. The armor will hold onto any armor you buy and he'll let you swap them out whenever you want. Well, we should probably look at some of the armor, see if we can. We'd be advised to invest in that. Another knight with a shovel. Just one of you guys earlier, but he was scary looking. What's this frog say? I'm so grumpy, he's not in a good mood. Wish someone could cheer me up. I'll give it a shot. Okay, well. Why would they just leave the catapult unattended? The operator's out to launch. Yeah, I agree. All this armor clanging about, what an awful racket. Well, I suppose there are quite a few armored persons here. Once I beat an area's leader, I can return to get the stuff I missed before. That makes it easy. I don't know, I mean, does this stage really change that much? Other than the boss being absent. What happened to your sword, Sir Knight? Well, maybe it's a very sharp shovel. Stocking up an item, that way I can't lose my gold in the field. Well, you also get gold in the field, so that's... That only works to some extent. So, 3 minutes this morning, what did you do? Well, I needed to go into more detail. Look for the donkey on my mother's side. I see. Thank you for sharing that. Spending money or save up is a risk of losing it all worth it. I mean, what's the point of saving up if you have the ability to spend it and you just run the risk of losing it? Are we missing anybody? Probably a few, but I don't know what they would look like. Language like lovers, while treasure knight sails under the waves in his dreaded iron whale. His treachery scares all the fish in the sea, do us a favor and thrash him for me. Bag of oats weighs a ton. Well, were you meant to carry a ton of oats? someplace. What about this chick? That King Knight is so regal, such a refined fashion sense. Honestly, I'd rather be your queen. I see. Thank you for sharing that person I've never met. I don't think a horse maiden like me and a guy like you could, well, I don't want to hear the end of that sentence either, thank you. If you meet someone on the road you must battle, then I suspect we might just do that, and exactly that in just a minute, but... Well, let's actually go ahead here and see what we got. Mr. Hat looks like very stripped down, kind of ancient helmet. The greatest passion, even though he's not even wearing a hat, unless you count that helmet itself as a hat. Nothing I enjoy more than the crisp snap of a well-tailored brim. As you can see, my brimmed helmet. With my vast riches, I could buy this whole store, but I forgot my wallet. Part with a paltry 1,000 gold, no. You forgot your wallet too, yes, yes, that's exactly it, thank you. I can definitely afford 1,000 gold, but... I only the best, and for my latest purchase, unfortunately, I'm only 1,000 gold short, oh really. I'm good for it, yeah, I believe you, totally. Such a charming beret, if only I had means to afford it, I mean, 1,000 gold, well... Anywhere else I can go? I suppose not. Well, I'm pretty sure that we did see the... You know, the ladder that, I guess, leads to some kind of airship up there, but... Can we actually access that right now? Can we access the, you know... We can access the ladder, but not the fucking roof that put a note scroll on it that's right next to it. Oh well. Speed the aerial anvil. Need an armor upgrade. Well, we have a regular armor. I'm pretty sure that I managed to get all of these armors on my last run of the game. Wonder if that will be the same this time. Drop half as much gold when you fall in battle, which could definitely be useful. Sacrifice some protection for a higher magic limit. Harvest magic from defeated foes. That seems not really similar to the way I've been doing things. Perform two consecutive shovel drops and unleash a powerful charge slash. It seems very situational. And, like these two are... Technically beyond the scope of what we can afford, you know, but heavily plated keep your footing when struck by enemies, but stopping may be a problem. Oh boy. Yeah, I don't know if that would be very convenient in some of the platforming you have to do. And then flashy acrobatic useless, even though I'm pretty sure from what I remember this was the armor that I was using when I beat the game. First time I went through it, and you do get a couple of extra dialogues. That's only a couple of moments when you're wearing that. Nice shovel blade you have there, but I can improve it and unlock its true abilities, really. Hold your attack to unleash a powerful charge last. This does seem like it's probably gonna be the most useful thing we can get right now. Take up a whole pile in one mighty motion, that seems, very situational. Slash to spark the ground when you're at full health, also very situational, so I think we'll get that. Well, maybe. Depending on what we find here. Horns, the finest instruments, but they only really come to life in a duet. Oh well, guess we'll not be experiencing that then. To say, sir, why I haven't seen such a decadent airship since I sold mine. Wonder how much money we, like, so many of these people have available. We'll be getting this first, I suppose. Get that there, charge slash. Maybe even try it out now. Oh. It's gonna be a range thing, but yeah, this might still be worthwhile if we can, like, do it properly. But since we can't really afford any more of the upgrades that actually do something here, I guess we can lend this guy some money. Can't believe that worked. Oh god, okay. Running out of the customers one by one, the hats are going. How shall I restock? Okay, I guess that's gonna happen with all of them. Can't live without it, but yeah. I'm guessing that once they've all left, for that same reason, something else will happen, but... But for now, why don't I go ahead and... You'll meet this other person on the road. These other two people on the road, oh god, which I think are just like... Battles. Race. North from Pridemore, west at the fork. Must have passed it already. This may be references to other internet things that I am completely unaware of myself. Maybe you can help me. I think I got lost. I was trying to... Wait a second, you're the knight with a shovel. The knight with a shovel who has been menacing the village. You're gonna use that shovel to bury innocent people? Well, I mean... What else would you use to do that? A bulldozer? It's gonna be interesting. Should probably try to use my, you know, expel items here, considering that not be seeing any kind of a use so far. God. Of course, he's got the whole thing where if you get touched, even if it's the enemy's not in an attack animation, you lose health, but of course the same thing does not happen with the enemy. Don't know if I'm gonna be able to, you know, out-DPS this guy right now. Hold on, push the wrong button. Let's see, maybe, I guess we can escape all danger. Can we still attack? And we have that active, and apparently the answer is yes, so hold on. Oh shit, that's bad. Oh, I'm one hit away from death, hold on. Oh, and I forgot to refill these things, I guess we can use that too. You know, maybe we don't need to use magic if we just keep on the exploiter to rest our items like so. Come on, please give me more range. That'd be like the best upgrade that I can get so far. And we did it in a perfectly balanced fashion. The worst villain. I'm no villain, we're fighting a common enemy, which is the other knight with a shovel. I feel like a fool now. Well, think nothing of it, knights are strongest when they work together. Knight's code, first vow, always help a person in need. Knock him down, shovel knight. Just like I've been knocked down by you, striking me over the head repeatedly with that shovel in question. I guess we do have the, you know, the extra note scrolls that we've been gathering, so we can trade those for money and get more stuff that way at this precise time. So I'm also gonna see what's up with that guy, but first let's refill our chalice, sis. Let's get that one. And let's get that one again. I don't really see myself wanting to get either of the other ones. At least not at this time. Only that guy's within reach, which he is, okay. Oh yeah, what's over there to the right? I suppose we also unlock that, but I haven't been to check it out yet. That's what I think is definitely supposed to be like a thing from the internet trademark, but it seems to be a popular enough thing that I am completely unaware of it, still, after all these years. Best gear, the slickest armor, the strongest rope. Stuck up order of no quarter clowns have no idea what they're missing. You look like a knight. I'm not a league, so I heard that if you beat a knight, you get to take their title, right? Well, even though I'm not part of that group either. Great best knight, like the sound of that. Though I have no choice but to accept me now. With my lasso power, I suppose. Sort of bootleg Belmont, Simon Belmont swing as well. Oh, she's probably trying to bounce on double hand when he does that. Seems like probably have a greater effect. Oh boy. Yep, hope if we can, you know, actually trigger it. Oh god, what the fuck? Trigger probably and not get surprised by that sudden flash of lightning being unleashed. Oh gosh. Where is that lightning coming from? Oh shit. Apparently we're liable to take more than 1.5 point of damage at a time in that fight. What do you know? Well, he's over there now. Let's take a look at what's here. All of champions. They'll be back over there in just a second, but first let's probably be turned away here. Living monument to the founders of this great land. Admission for one, that'll be 5,000 gold, please. Oh, jeez. Well, I can't even afford that right now. I mean, surely Hall of Champions isn't gonna be a reference to medieval. is the only thing that I can think of when I think of a Hall of Champions. Or did I just lose all that gold permanently? I suppose. And why the fuck does this guy not have like... or does have such a limited hit point, hitbox when it comes to... Well, it's not a limited hitbox, it's the fact that he's swinging that thing on top of his head. That's like supposed to give him immunity to being bounced on, I suppose. Oh, for fuck's sake. And then he does fake out like this. It's like... fucking rip hold on, let me... Okay, let me switch to Chalice. I'm not to realize that... in fact, I already have it selected. I have two, so I guess I'll just play it safe and pop one of them now and get the other one handy. Moment there, probably because this guy bounced, but there we go. Too bad, I'm pretty sure I just ended up with a net loss of money on that encounter. I can almost afford being able to get into that stupid Hall of Champions at least. And accept defeat like a true knight, you'll always have your dignity. Well, they'll never let me into the order. Well. If we can continue to exploit him, that would definitely be ideal. I could just walk away at this time, there is no input required on my part. Well, this does warrant a drink, I would say. If I can... what the fuck is going on with this thing? Hold on. I got a little spring mechanism on my bottle. Get fucked up, I can't open this thing. Oh no, hold on. I don't know what was going on, but okay, got it unstuck at least. Okay, there, it snaps, which tells me that we can still make it work. That's good. That warrants progression at least. Being freed of that particular burden. Alright, let's see. I guess we're gonna refill our chalices real quick. Just in case I end up forgetting to do this when I come back to this. I'm pretty much done like I mentioned, but... oh yes, I am sure. But for now, since I do have the means to do so, I'll at least see if I can get a couple more of those... expenses. Wait a minute, what? Oops, I picked the wrong place because I'm not paying attention. Wait, what? Okay. Or maybe I didn't. If we can find something else over here, maybe I'll... maybe not. I could say maybe I'll redo this if there's, like, something else that you can get, which apparently there is, but... I mean, can you leave the... thing? I guess we'll go back for that page at a later time. But right now, I'm just gonna go ahead and go to the village, that's where I'm meant to go. Should have some quantity of pages. 7 pages to return, is that right? Okay. Get all that money, you found the Dance Macabre. Dead crowd tonight says, I lesson learned. It says I. Okay. Totally misread that. I thought they were making a joke about someone else with that name. Lesson learned, never crack jokes in a graveyard. Never ever. Now that I have this music sheet, can perform it for you anytime, so I guess with what we've returned, we can hear what we already heard, fighting with Orbites. Watch me dance, spin the bottle, adventure awaits, strike the earth, dig and dandy, rival. You can also use L&R, which I did not realize until now. Because it's not really, signaled in the screen here. Ultra Antimony, Vital Vitriol. What are the rest of these? Steal a shovel, choose a nickname, Beautiful Knight, Decisive Blow. Actually, I'm not even sure what context this is. No weapons here. I'll just return it to the default town theme for now. And this guy doesn't sell anymore, right? Yeah. No more meal tickets for now, at least. Probably get more magic upgrades, but I don't know if I'm gonna bother with that right now. I mean, the ones that I've gotten so far have not really been making a difference the way that I'm playing. King of Fruit and Fish, may his stem grow. Well, this guy has merchandise, does he? Alchemy coin, toss a coin for a chance at riches. Presumably it's one time buy, so I guess we'll do that. Toss a coin for a chance at riches. If you're lucky, you can win big. Oh boy, well, I guess we can use the magic we have right now to test that out. Doesn't seem to have done much right now. Oh well, maybe we just did it in the wrong place. Maybe we should have approached a well or something and tried to do that, but well. Like I just said. Let's see, 2000. Still doesn't seem very worthwhile, considering that we probably have better options at this point. Let's go for the motions here. We can probably maybe get different results from this guy if we get the ability that lets us. Oh shit, okay. Well, that just happened. Yeah, that seems like the appropriate reaction. Still not too sure how we're supposed to get that page up there. Oh well. So we'll go to the other town and see what we can get from here. We can spend 2,000 gold presumably and getting the rich people to leave the shop. They're still here, but if we did that, would that be reconcilable with trying to get something else that looks like it might actually be useful from, well, yeah, we have money back, so I was gonna say, this looks like a well. Can we just toss a coin in the well and get something? But I guess not. We need 3,000 for dropping half so much gold. We should probably get this, honestly. I feel like this is the only thing that's available right now that seems like it's, you know, objectively useful. Now we have the red armor on hand, and I guess we can spend the rest of this money on getting one more of these fuckers to leave the shop. Sure, whatever. Well, at least she says thank you, so that's a slightly more polite than the other one. Just one more customer, and then there's no more hats. No more hats. Must get more hats. Unfortunately, we can't make that happen right now, so oh well. I suppose that is the state that the world shall be left in at this time. Let me just go ahead and, you know, turn to the title screen and then go back into the game just to confirm my very boldly confirm my theory that yes, we are in fact making progress and that we don't have to manually save that progress. Yeah. On challenge mode. I don't even know what most of this stuff is for. Feats, is that just achievements? Probably, yeah. To finish the game. Other stuff that, yeah, we've done in the past. Definitely not finish the game with anybody but Shovel Knight, though. But we should have a few of these, at least. Some of the other characters, as you can tell. I guess I didn't. Oh god, I did way less with fucking Plague Knight than I thought I did. So let's go ahead and, you know, exit for now. That will be where we leave things off for the time being, but I think I should be glad to have, you know, begun one more thing that was kind of pending. That I've been kind of due to re-experience for quite some time now, even though I have experienced at least part of it before, like I mentioned. Let's see. Ooh. And kind of fortuitously, I am being reminded of something that I probably should have. Should have done a while ago. But which I will attend to in just a minute, because first, let me see if I can't bring back the music here, so we can play this out. And yeah, hopefully I'm able to keep doing a few more streams in this capacity. I'll do it, nope, I want to go to this screen, I want to go to, you know, this one, the one that actually matches the fact that we're ending the stream. Probably a good thing, probably a good place to be on, and yeah. We are calling it for now, but I will hopefully be able to return before, you know, another 2 months pass. I can continue to make time for this kind of thing. I have kind of broken away from a certain rhythm that I was locked into the last couple of months, and I'm not really sure if I will be locked into any other ones in the immediate near future. In any description, but I will try to keep, see if I can make, keep on making time for, you know, streams and stuff, regardless. But for now, I will be continuing with this, with Prune Factory, I suppose, whenever that's up, and whatever else I may think of, probably mostly just those wheel streams, otherwise if it's not one of those two things, for the time being at least. And with all that being said, I don't believe I have anything more to add as I continue to click things and be distracted. I should probably do that, you know, on my own time. Not while I'm still running the stream, so I will proceed to make that a thing now. So, we'll take it easy. I thank everybody for coming, like always. Thanks for chatting. Always wait for other people chat. And just thanks everyone for dropping by, and I will be seeing you all later. Not too much later, I hope, but later.